Welcome my dear friends. So in this video we are going to see the Canterbury Tales. So which is the famous work of Geoffrey Chaucer. In the last video we had seen about the characterization and contribution of the Geoffrey Chaucer. So in this video we are going to analyze about the Canterbury Tales and also what are the important characters we have in that Canterbury Tales. So Chaucer's Canterbury Tales influenced by Boccaccio's Decameron. So this Chaucer, he created this work Canterbury Tales by the imitation and influence of this Boccaccio's Decameron. So this Canterbury Tales, it contains 29 pilgrims. So those 29 pilgrims meet at Tabard Inn. This is a place, Tabard Inn, and 23 of them tell stories. So there are 24 stories. Chaucer tells two stories, so this is very important. Those two stories are Tale of Topas and Tale of Melipeus. The Canterbury Tales begins with, this is the first story, that is Knight's Tale. And this Canterbury Tales, the last story is, it ends with Parson's Tale. So it ends with retraction. Chaucer's apology for the vulgar and unworthy part of this book. So these things are important in the Canterbury Tales. And next we are going to see important characters. So what are the important characters created by this Chaucer in this Canterbury Tales? So if you take characters, so first one is the knight, the squire, the prioress, the monk, the prior, the pardoner, the summoner, the parson, the clerk of export, the municipal, and then the merchant, the man of law, the franklin, the five guildmen, the wife of Bath, and the physician, the yeoman, the reeve, and then the cook, the miller. So if you see detail about these characters, so the first character is the knight character. So he is a member of this household group, and he represents ideas of truth, honor, generosity, courtesy, modesty, and gentleness. And first to arrive at Tabard Inn after Chaucer. So after the arrival of Chaucer, this is the first person who came to this Tabard Inn. And well, he traveled and prudent. So he traveled many places and he is a prudent. And tells first tale, Knight's Tale. So he is the first teller and he tells about the Knight's Tale. Next character, the squire, is the son of the knight. And he was as fresh as the month of May. So this squire character is described by Chaucer as fresh as the month of May. And bought battles for winning his lady loves. So he fought for the lady loves, and he winning for his lady loves. And he is humble and modest, tells an oriental tale. So this choir, his story is oriental tale. And the prioress, the next character, a prioress, and her name was Eclantine. So Eclantine was his name, her name. And she was beautiful, romantic, and amiable. She had fine table manners, loves small talks more than human beings. So she was very much likes dogs if you compare with human beings. And next character, the monk, compared to the prioress in religious affection. So he was very much affected by religious. And the next, robust and muscular man. So monk travels with the prioress and a second nun. So the prior is supposed to live a poor life by begging, but is more interested in affairs of young people. So this character is a good singer. And the next character, the pardoner, Chaucer's masterpiece in character drawing. So this pardon is very much most beautiful character, which is given by Chaucer, this pardoner character. And this is a masterpiece in Chaucer's character. And he is a good storyteller, sings Hymens beautifully. And the summoner, the next character, the summoner. So Foreigner's companion. He is a companion of Foreigner. And lecturer's handler, dishonest. Children are afraid of his fiery red face, full of pimples and scary eyebrows. So his appearance is full of a different one because of his fiery red face and also scary eyebrows. So he thinks afraid, making afraid to the children. And he loves garlic, onion, leeks and wine. As part of few Latin phrases, he knows. And the next character, the person, so his ideal parish priest thought only holy thoughts and did only good deeds. He is very gentle and diligent. And next character, the clerk of Oxford, so a neutral portrayal, devoted to the study of philosophy, so eager to learn and teach, prayed for the souls of those who helped him. He is polite and speaks only when necessary. He speaks about morality. His tale is a reply to the tale of a wife of Bath. It is about the patient wife, Griselda. The next character is a merchant. He is a wealthy businessman. He wore rich and multicolored clothes and hat from Holland. And the next character, the man of law, so wise and slightly suspicious of everything, and he had vast knowledge of law, often appointed by the king as a judge of the court of assizes. And next, when we see about the man of law, he is a wealthy land buyer. And Franklin, so this is another one character. So this Franklin is a companion of man of law and a wealthy gentleman who like to have wine in the morning. So next, because he loves a pleasure, he is called son of Epicurus. So that's why in the morning also he drank that wine. So next, at country meetings, he is representative and chairman. The Franklin's tale is story set in Brittany. And next one, the bicycleman. So the five bicyclemen, they have a five person in this characters. So those are, they are artisans and are newly rich, represents urban middle class. They are a haberdasher, a carpenter, a weaver, a dryer, and a tapestry maker. These five persons are known as the five guildsmen. And the next character, the wife of Bath. So Bath is famous for clothes making, and she was herself an expert in weaving and embroidery. So this wife of Bath is cloth making. He was very famous for this cloth making, and also expert in weaving and embroidering. So lived an honorable life while he traveled in Italy, Spain and Jerusalem. So loved to tell romantic tales and gossip. And next, a physician. So extremely good at his profession and astronomy. Knew of every disease and where it came from, and gives a cure immediately. It's a symbol that which is healthy. And he saved gold because of his love of gold. And the next character, the reeve, slender. So slender means thin and graceful. So main name, Oswald. So this reeve names, this reeve character, he has a name, Oswald. And the next, in change of his masters, sheep, cattle, dairy, swine and horses, stock and poultry. He could observe seasons, weather and foretell harvest. Also a good carpenter, a trade which he had learnt in youth. So he is a very good trade maker and also carpenter. So he was from his childhood, youth, from his youth. Not child, from his youth. And shipman, so lived in the western country, comes from Dartmouth, and foul and prudent. While he traveled to many places and expert in matters regarding the position of the moon and tides, the currents and the periods of the sea. And Hesiphus called the Magdalene. So this his ship name was the Magdalene. And Eamon, another one character, knew all techniques of carpentry and carried sword, gourd and a shield and a dagger. And he is a woodsman compared to Robin Hood. So here he compared to the Robin Hood. So he is a woodsman. So that's why this human compared to Robin Hood. And next, Mansiple worked at a college of lawyers and attended who purchases provisions for college and an inner court. He serves food to the lawyer and students at the temple. And despite his lack of education, this Mansiple is smarter than the 30 lawyers he feeds. And the next one, the cook. This character, his name is Roger. The cook is Roger. His name is Roger. He was employed by the guildsmen, those five persons, perfect in cooking food, and his masterpiece is minced chicken in white sauce. So he was a very good cook, and he working under this guildsman, and chicken in white sauce is his masterpiece. And next, a miller. His name is Robin. So fond of telling Indian tales, so he always telling Indian tales, and he tells the tale of a Baudi Babu. He wore white coat and blue hood, expert in grinding corn and stole corn by pushing the scales with his thumb. For which narrator's views, he had a golden thumb. So he stolen that corn and he grinding that corn, and also that's why this author, he called him as he has a golden thumb. So these are the characters which is drawn by Geoffrey Chaucer in his The Canterbury Tales. So in our next video, we will see what are the questions maybe asked from these Canterbury Tales to the NET exam 2019. And I want to remember that we are in the end of exam schedule. So the exam is very near to us. So I have given some of the videos and the details. I can't give more videos because of some device problem and also some personal reasons. So I hope that this video will be helpful to you, and we will meet in the next video. And what are the things may be asked from that Canterbury Tales. So we will meet in the next video. Thank you.